Anyways, Rose bought what she thought was butter the other day, Butterlicious, which is actually, you know, what we call margarine, right? And let's read the ingredients in the two. Let's see, and this is actually butter, or as close as you can get in the Philippines. Ingredients: butter fat, water, ionized salt, milk powder, buttermilk and or skim milk, natural flavor, soya lecithin as an emulsifier. Okay, that's the ingredients in the actual butter.
That's a good one.
Let's see this Butterlicious. that's so delicious. Now let's read what's in here. Ingredients: blend of vegetable oils, coconut oil, palm oil, fully hydrogenated palm stearine, and milk fat, water, skim milk powder, natural identical flavors. And that's an interesting phrase, natural and natural identical flavors. In other words, some kind of a chemical. Soy lecithin and monoglonosaccharines as an emulsifier, sodium benzoate and potassium sorbonate as preservatives, BHA and polygalate as antioxidants, vitamin A, beta carotene as colorant. So,
why they have so much ingredients on that?
It's because it's one molecule away from plastic. That's why.
Yeah.
And they throw in some powdered skim milk and call it butter. Now, which two would you guys rather eat? You know, this one with all those nice chemicals in there I can't even hardly pronounce, or this one?
Yeah.
Is buttermilk. Actually, margarine causes Alzheimer's and dementia.
Alzheimer's?
Yeah, it causes all kinds of problems. And so do vegetable oils, seed oils as they call it. Coconut oil is the only oil you should be using for frying. That or actual lard.
Yes.
From animal fat.
That's what we're using now.
Yep.
The lard of the pork.
Coconut oil and avocado oil and a good olive oil.
Avocado oil?
Yeah.
I haven't heard of that.
So, they're not necessarily for frying. That's more for like flavoring.
Okay.
Like don't
you? Yeah.
So, anyways, that's what's causing a lot of our health problems. And the other one is sugar. I mean, the biggest one is sugar. The amount of sugar they have and everything. The processed foods, but, you know, just doing the seed oils thing is a big deal. I mean, that's, you think about it, you know, McDonald's used to use lard.
Yeah.
You know, actual animal fat to do their french fries. Well, then the government made them put pressure on them to stop using that with this whole cholesterol thing, right?
Yeah.
Everything. And guess what? Your body needs tons of cholesterol. And they're making you sick by lowering your cholesterol.
Yeah, and the doctors keep saying, oh, your cholesterol is high. You have to lower it down.
Of course, the pharmaceutical companies are the ones that dictate all this. Because what's the first thing they do? We've got a pill for that. Your cholesterol is too high. Well, too high in relation to what? What studies do you have that show that cholesterol, higher cholesterol, is causing this stuff? It's not.
Yeah.
It's all bullshit. Actually, they're causing it all by lowering your cholesterol. Cholesterol is the actual building block that your body needs to... I mean, your cells, all your cell membranes are made out of cholesterol, the outside part. Your brain is primarily cholesterol, you know, like 99% cholesterol or a version thereof, and your body actually uses cholesterol to repair damage in your like your blood system.
Yeah.
Like it gets scraped and messed up from other stuff. Well, cholesterol is what comes in, and it's a band-aid, it's a patch on an injury. And so they're blaming cholesterol. It's like the analogy, you know, it's funny, anytime there's a fire, firemen show up. And so obviously the firemen are what are causing the fire, right? So that's how it is. Don't listen to this cholesterol stuff. There's been a lot of studies that people that have higher cholesterol actually live longer than people who have low cholesterol. And those statin drugs, there are tons and tons of side effects of those things. Statin drugs. I won't mention names because YouTube probably wouldn't like that.
Yeah.
But, you know, all the statin drugs that...
Let's say processed drugs.
Lower your cholesterol. Actually are damaging and destroying your body. They're just not telling you, you know. How many of you people, you know, go to the doctor, oh, your cholesterol is high. You know, we got to lower that. Look, we happen to have a pill for that, you know. So it's, you're being fed a bunch of crap. The biggest thing to stay away from is sugar.
And do you know if by keep going back to the doctor will not really help you a lot, especially if they give you another medications and every pain?
They don't cure the problem, hon. What they do is the symptoms, in other words, you know, cover it up.
Yeah.
Type of thing. And meanwhile, that pill that they're giving you is doing different damage to your body. Right?
Yeah.
And then, you know, that damage is there, and then you go and, oh, well, we got a pill for that damage too.
Yeah.
So it's a never evolving thing.
Yeah.
Eat lots of red meat, protein, eat lots of eggs, and use butter instead of margarine. Stay away from margarine. There weren't any cases of Alzheimer's until after the 50s is when they switched over to pushing margarine, you know, low cholesterol, this and that. Originally, they invented margarine to feed the pigs to fatten them up. Right, which that and the vegetable oils, they're kind of all in this same category.
And did you say it was also used for lubricants or something?
Yeah, they used to use it as a lubricant. That's vegetable oils. But anyways, they used to feed it to the pigs to fatten them up, which it did. But unfortunately, 6 months later, all the pigs were dying from heart attacks.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Seriously. So they stopped using it for that, right? All the farmers, well, what good is that? It just kills the pigs. And so they said, well, it hasn't been proven to do that in humans. Let's market it to humans. And that's, lo and behold, where margarine came from and the whole thing about, ooh, cholesterol levels. And guess who sets the cholesterol levels? The pharmaceutical companies.
Yeah.
Well, yeah. There's a lot of research out there that if your cholesterol is under 200, you're dying. You're dying because it's like your body is starved for cholesterol.
Yeah.
So, anyways.
They didn't finish it.
Yeah. And the food pyramid, that's a total joke. Take that pyramid and take the stuff that you're supposed to eat the most of, and move it up to the very top, make it the least. And the stuff they say to eat the least of, move it to the bottom and make it the most.
Yeah.
Invert it. Because, trust me, the whole food industry is designed to make you sick as well. It's all, you know, big money. Follow the money. Try going to the doctor and getting the hell out of there without a prescription or something. Ask your doctor, well, what's alternative? What kind of nutrition can I? Obviously, they're going to say, you know, lose weight and diet, but they're not going to tell you what foods you should and shouldn't eat.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of a thing, you know, because there's did you guys know that eggplant has a bunch of nicotine in it? And it's funny, since nicotine is supposed to be the addictive ingredient in cigarettes, right? Why then, if when you eat eggplant, doesn't your body go, hey, I feel really good when I eat that. How come your body doesn't crave having more eggplant, more eggplant, more eggplant? They try to cover it up by saying that, well, no, it's not in large enough concentration to cause that. Well, it's like, I don't think so. That's just their cover story.
Yeah.
I mean, if nicotine's addictive, nicotine's addictive. Whether you smoke one cigarette a day or you smoke three packs a day,
yeah,
you're still addicted to the nicotine, right? And nicotine actually has a lot of health benefits. Against Alzheimer's is one of them. Aren't Alzheimer's, Parkinson's disease, there's a list of about 15 diseases that nicotine actually helps cure. And during the good old COVID days, there were countries that made selling cigarettes illegal during COVID. Why? Because people who smoked and got all that nicotine didn't get COVID anywhere near as much as people who didn't.
Do they have strong resistance?
Huh? No, nicotine is a, I don't know, it does something to the virus, it kills it, or makes it where it can't reproduce, and that's why the government has had the attack on smoking, right, for years and years and years. Well, you think the pharmaceutical companies don't know about this and nicotine? And so it's like, what are they going to do if people are smoking and they're not getting sick, right? You're sick as much. So let's do a war on smoking so that people stop smoking, and that way they'll get sick more and we can sell them our pills. You know, our legalized concoction of nicotine that they cook up, you know. Anytime they involve heat in making any kind of thing to put in your body, stay away from it, because they're altering the structure of it from what it's supposed to be, and it messes it up. Plain and simple, stop putting all these chemicals in your body. We don't need them. Your body can't process them, and so off that goes. Yeah, and so anyways, the people, you have to wake up and start questioning everything that the government's been telling you. I go under the analogy of this. If the government tells you to do something, don't do it. If the government tells you not to do something, do it. That's how it is, because it's all rigged. To follow the money. It's all rigged to make people sick, and so they're constantly having to. They don't kill you right away. They just want you. They want you sick for 70 years. They act. They're moving down now where they're cardiovascular disease. Yeah, disease is moving down. It's now moving down into the point where people in there's a huge increase in people in their 30s and 40s that have, you know, and normally they didn't get that until they're in like their 70s or 80s type of thing. And that age has been moving down, and you know, and so you have to look, what's causing this? I mean, it just doesn't naturally pop up, you know. I mean, all of a sudden, what, cigarette smoking is caused? Well, they've had a war on smoking, and not a lot of people, nowhere near as many people smoke nowadays as they did back in the, you know, 50s and 60s.
Yeah. Right?
Well, how come the disease rate and heart attack rates and lung cancer and all of this hasn't plummeted, right? Because it hasn't. It's increased. So, obviously, it's not tobacco that's causing the problem. They like to make you think it is, but it's not. Actually, I think the tobacco was actually keeping people healthier. I'm not condoning smoking, don't get me wrong, you know, kind of a thing. But it's not the enemy like they're making it out to be. They're protecting the real enemies of our body and promoting them.
Yeah.
Because it's all about this. Here, this is what it's about. It's all about this. What is this anyways?
I think that's multivitamins.
Bio-Z?
It's organic from Synergia.
There's no such thing as
organic.
No such thing as organic.
Okay, so.
So anyways, yeah. You open your eyes, guys. Don't just sit there and follow it. Look at what happened with COVID. It's coming out now that more people died from the jab than it saved.
Yeah.
Type of thing. And did it keep you from getting it? No. And actually, people got it more. And it's breaking down your immune system. It's giving people blood clots. It's giving them cancer. It's giving them all kinds of stuff. And it's just begun as far as what those vaccines are going to do to the body. Because it's a progressive thing. It's doing damage more and more and more every day because it alters your DNA.
Yeah.
That's that new RMA or whatever the technology they call it. It's the first time they've ever used it.
Yeah.
And it alters your DNA. Well, your the way your body works is every time it, you know, divides a cell, dies and or a cell, you know, divides, guess what? That DNA is now in the new cell, and every time it makes a replication, you know, it's going to get worse and worse and worse and worse. So, and that's why they want, you know, one dose didn't have the effect we wanted it to have. So, go and get your booster, and then go and get another booster. So, anyways, just use your own common sense, guys. So. That's my story, and I'm sticking to it. Bye, guys.